J-Shrek. I'm here with John, and we are on Antelope Hill. We're looking for the infamous outlaw, John J. Glanton. And he wrote his name somewhere on these walls, or on these rocks up here, somewhere on this mountain right here. And we think we got a good idea where in the hell it's at. You know, one thing it looked like it was going to be was fairly level. And that, John, is not fairly level.
Not for me, it isn't.
Holy crap. But that looks like the rock of the infamous John J. Glanton. A lot of people that don't know John J. Glanton, he was a, I better say infamous, not famous, but infamous outlaw that was a scalp hunter. One of the most brutal people that ever existed in the state of Arizona. And he wrote his name on the wall up here in 1850. Man, how many years ago was that? 170 years ago? And was killed that year in Yuma. But I think by the Yavapai killed him because they had, they were in competition with him over a ferry that was running across the Colorado River. So we're going to see. We think that's our rock right up there, but we're not sure. Look how steep this thing is. The picture didn't look like this. So we're going to get up here, walk this road, and see if something we've been looking for a long, long time. I mean a long time. Is up on this hill. Now, he would have walked this very road right here. And I wonder why this was the rock he chose. Who knows? Now, the river could have been closer 170 years ago. He might be right on the banks, but I'm telling you what, that is going to be a steep climb. The sun's going to help us a little bit, but that is the rock that we are looking for right there.
I'm old and fat, out of shape.
Well, as they say in adventure porn, it ain't going to hike itself. So the best we can do is get our ass up that hill. Man, it's a lot steeper than I thought it was. But if we get over here, I think we'll be fine. But let's get up. Man, this is one of the things I've been looking for a long time, man. But this is not, this is pretty hairy. It's not going to be easy. But we're going to get up it. We're going to follow the footsteps of the infamous outlaw, John J. Glanton, who was made infamous and famous by Blood Meridian. And by God, there he is right there. Holy shit. There is Glanton right up there. Man. Wow. He is up there. This is like a hill full of oh shit rocks. Man, there ain't an easy way up this thing. This thing is, it ain't, I never imagined it would be like this. I thought once we found it, it would be, how much we've already found. Man, I'm excited though, wow. Holy crap. There he is. He would have walked up this very hill and scrambled his name up there so the whole world could see. There's been a few people that's made this track, I can tell. Man, I never dreamed it was this steep. But there he is. Man, J.J. Glanton, wow. Elamert, is that what it is right here? There's the 1850 right there. There's J.D. Glanton. There's another name over there. And this would have been parts of his crew. Telling you what, this is a lot steeper. Man, there's some history right there. Incredible. Wow. Tell you what. I tell you, I never dreamed it was this steep. Man, coming down is going to be the bitch. Coming up is actually pretty good. Now, what is this one? Hopefully, when I get home, I can read this a little better. This top one. Oh, Smith. So, something Smith. There's Smith right there. S-M-I-T-H. S-M-I-T-H. J.J. John J. Glanton. And then now, these would have been members of his party. You know, I'm going to have to send this to the guy that wrote Blood Meridian and show him that the characters that his were portrayed in his book were right up here. Isn't this incredible? Look how steep a climb this thing is. You know, what makes this incredible is that for years, and we're talking thousands of years, all different tribes came here on Antelope Hill. Because the matates that they had, the grinding the stone, the consistency of the stone was perfect to be able to make grinding stones for. So there was kind of a truce on Antelope Hill that once you were here, you know, this was a free land that there was no skirmishes between them. So what you find on this mountain is you find a bunch of people, different groups that had different petroglyphs, and they were all based on basically, you know, what tribes, but they all came here and they had a truce on this land that while they were here, they could get their business done, you know, build their matates and then leave and take them home. So there has been stones all over the Arizona area of where they have found these matates that came from this location all over from Casa Grande all the way to here, Escalante, Sears Point. All over these people traveled to here to get specific stones because they grinded the best. You know, it's incredible to be sitting here, you know, in this mountaintop. Halfway up, it's not a mountaintop, but I tell you what, we're going to have a hell of a time getting down here. The easy part was getting up. The hard part's going to be not getting, going down. But we'll get down. We'll just take our time and go one at a time, even if we got to get on our butt and slide down here. We're going to get down here, but I'm telling you what, just to be here in this history, though, is pretty incredible. I'd have never dreamed that this was in such a, you know, a extremely steep area. John, what do you think?
I think it's crazy up here.
You know, here we are at where John J. Glanton, it looked like two other of his members, but, you know, that might be one name across. There's Smith on the very end. And L. Moret Smith, maybe, or it's two names, but there is J.J. Glanton right here, and there is the infamous 1850 right there. I mean, isn't that incredible? I mean, Selfie City. I think when I go down, I'm going to head down those rocks right there. Boy, that's instant. Go to the bottom. I don't know if you guys can tell how steep this is, but I'm telling you what, this is straight up. I mean, it's straight up. It's incredible. Okay, I finally figured it out. Now that I've looked at it 50 times, I think I got it. I think it's Elmer Smith is who that is. So I'm taking it that Elmer was a part of JJ's group. I think I'm done today. And, wow, another one off the list. 1850. Man. If you look up there, you can see where they have milled stones off of that rock. You see where that light color is? Where they have milled up there. Isn't that unbelievable? It's incredible. Wow. Unbelievable. You know, right across there would have been the first attempt to cross the Gila River back in the day by automobile. Now, if you go through here and you look at any of this location here, you're going to find a lot of different petroglyphs, only because, you know, every group of ancients used this for milling purposes. And then what happened was we had a major flood. So they decided to mill the side of the mountain to be able to have flood control. But the original milling took place when they decided to put this bridge across here as well. Now, right there, if you could see through these trees, that would have been the location of the stagecoach. Would have been right on the other side of that this hill right here. And then right here, you'll find all kinds of different petroglyphs along this area that of the different tribes that came here to mill this mountain. We don't have time to do that today, but you know what? What a great day this been. We found Mr. Glanton, and I'll tell you what, we've been hunting Mr. Glanton down forever. And finally, that search is over with. What's the next one? Well, I'll tell you next episode. Jace Wreck, Black Flag Expeditions.